فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The more less knowledge you will attain. ومثال العلم, and knowledge is like في القلب in the heart كنور المصباح. It is like the light of the candle. Knowledge in the heart is like a candle. إن صفى زجاجه شعت أنواره. If its glass becomes clean, شعت أنواره, its light will glow. Take a lamp today, clean the glass, look at the light, it becomes very bright. SubhanAllah, don't even do something else. Take your laptop, clean the screen. You see, take the baby wipes, clean your screen. Look what happens to your laptop. You think you got a new laptop. صح? Clean, crystal clean, you can see everything. You think the, where? You start to think what? That, what's it called, the screen? The retina. Is it called retina?
Resolution.
The resolution, you feel like it's increased, and subhanAllah, has something happened to my... That's exactly how the heart is. If the heart is cleaned, the knowledge is like that inside the heart. It becomes clean, the knowledge comes out. شَعَتْ أَنْوَارُهُ. Whenever you clean that glass, what happens? The knowledge comes out. The light comes out. وَإِلَّا اتَّخَتْهُ الْأَوْسَاخُ كَسَفَتْ أَنْوَارُهُ. And whenever dirt and taint covers it, كَسَفَتْ أَنْوَارُهُ, it darkens its light. The word كَسَفَتْ comes from the word كُسُوف. صح? Which you all know, is it called eclipse? That's what happens, the heart gets closed like that. كَسَفَتْ أَنْوَارُهُ, the person, the nur is blocked. فَمَنْ أَرَادَ حِيَازَةُ الْعِلْمِ. Anyone who wants to understand knowledge, anyone who wants to attain knowledge, anyone who wants to keep in knowledge, فَلْيُزَيِّنْ بَاطِنَهُ وَيُطَحِّرْ قَلْبَهُ. Beautify and adorn your internal. وَيُطَحِّرْ قَلْبَهُ, clean your heart. مِنْ نَجَاسَتِهِ, from dirt and filth. فَالْعِلْمُ جَوْهَرٌ. Knowledge is a jawhar. Jawhar is a valuable stone. It's any stone that's valuable. Gold, silver, pearls, rubles, all of them are what? They are jawhar. Latif means light. لا يصلح إلا للقلب النظيف. Sorry, فضل.
فمن أراد حيازة العلم فليزين باطنه ويطهر قلبه من نجاسته. فالعلم جوهر نظيف لا يصلح إلا للقلب النظيف. وطهارة القلب ترجع إلى أصلين عظيمين, أحدهما طهارته من نجاسة الشبهات, والآخر طهارته من نجاسة الشهوات. ولما لطهارة القلب من شأن عظيم أمر بها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في أول ما أمر, في قوله تعالى في سورة المدثر وثيابك فطهر, في قول من يفسر الثياب بالباطن, وهو قول حسن له مأخذ صحيح.
The author رحمه الله محافظه الله, he says وطهارة القلب ترجع إلى أصلين عظيمين. The purity and cleaning your heart goes back to two foundations. Do you want to clean your heart? There are two things it goes back to that you have to clean from your heart. It's called najasatul qalb. These are the ran, kalla bal ran ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. The taint and the dirt that covers a person's heart that doesn't allow them. لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا. He can't even recognize the truth. He can't reject the falsehood. The dirt that's making this happen to him is one of these two. أحدهما, the first one is طهارته من نجاسة الشبهات, the dirt of doubt. And as we said, شبهات is what? برزق بين الحق والباطل. It's a station. Like the قبر is what? Is a برزق بين دار الدنيا ودار الآخرة, right? شبهات is a برزق بين الحق والباطل. It's a station in between the haq and the batil. And we said, the reason why we say it's a station in between is because the shubuhat, the clothing it's wearing is the haq. And the body and the skin is falsehood. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْحَقَّ وَلَا تَلْبِسُ الْحَقَّ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتَكْتُمُ الْحَقَّ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. So this person, what is he wearing? His truth, from the parent he looks like haqq. But when he's investigated more, it's found out that it's falsehood. And shubuhat, my brothers and sisters, is one thing that makes a person believe in what he's doing. Because of the conviction that he comes with, and because it can fool a person. As you all know, AbdulRahman ibn Muljib was the man who killed who? Ali ibn Abi Talib. He's the one who killed who? Ali ibn Abi Talib. He was getting close to Allah by killing Ali ibn Abi Talib. This man is getting closer to who? يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ بِقَتْلِ ابْنَ عَمِّ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Getting close to enter Jannah. He's looking for a station in Jannah. To kill who? The cousin of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. وَلِذَلِكَ عِمْرَانِ ابْنُ حِطَّانِ. حِطَّان is the correct way of saying it. Many people say حَطَّان. It's not. It's بِكَسْرِ الْحَائِ. It's حِطَّان. عِمْرَانِ ابْنُ حِطَّان, who came after Abdurrahman ibn Muljim, who was a khariji khabith, he read lines of poetry. This is what shubuhat does to you. Is it me? No problem. You can always pray if you want. Imran ibn Hittan, what did he say? Ya darbatan min taqiyyin ma arada biha illa liyablugha min dhil arshi ridwana inni la adhkuruhu yawman fa ahsibuhu aw fal bariyyati 'inda Allah mizana. What he saying? Ya darbatan min taqiyyin ma arada biha illa liyablugha dhil arshi ridwana. He says a smack that Abdurrahman ibn Muljim put to Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ya darbatan, a hitting, min taqiyyin, from a person who has taqwa. He's saying this to Abdurrahman ibn Muljim, praising him, the one who killed Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ya darbatan min taqiyyin, the hitting of a taqi. Ma arada biha, I did not intend from this hitting, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's all he accepted. This is the shubha, and this is the hujjatu. Man dalla an sawa'i sabil, the ones who become misguided from the straight path, all they say to you is, wallahi, he intended good. He wanted good from this. Ma arada illa wajha Allah. He didn't intend except the face of Allah. Is that enough? Brothers, is that enough? Ikhlas, is it enough? Wa kam min muridin lil khayri lam yusibhu. How many people wanted good but never got it? Sah? He's saying to you that Abdurrahman ibn Muljim's hitting of Ali ibn Abi Talib, he intended the face of Allah. He's a taqi. Inni la adhkuruhu. He said, I remember him. إِلَّا لِيَبْلُغَ مِنْ ذِي الْعَرْشِ رِضْوَانَ. He only did that so he can gain the high ranks of Allah that he set for him, and to get Allah to be pleased with him. إِنِّي لَأَذْكُرُهُ يَوْمًا. He says, I remember him sometimes, Abdurrahman ibn Muljim. Imran ibn Hittan is saying, I remember my friend Abdurrahman ibn Muljim. يَوْمًا فَأَحْسِبُهُ. And then I consider him, أَوْفَ الْبَرِيَّةِ. I consider him the most obedient creation, from the most obedient creations, عند الله ميزانا, in the scales of Allah. Why? How did he come to this conclusion? Shubha. He's going against, in this belief of his, that he believes that Ahman ibn Muljim is a taqi, and he intended the face of Allah, the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. One day the Prophet said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, to Ali, أَتَدْرِي مَنْ أَشْقَ الْأَوَّلِينَ. The Prophet said, Ali, oh Ali, do you know the most destroyed people from the early generations? Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam, Allah and his messenger know. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, aqiran naqah, is the one who cut the, what's this part called?
Achilles Hill.
And killed it from there. That's the first destroyed person. What does Allah say in Surah Shams? فَعَقَرُوا النَّاقَةَ. لا. لا, before that. وَأَشْقَاهَا إِذِنْ بَعَثَ أَشْقَاهَا فَقَالَ لَهُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ نَاقَةَ اللَّهِ وَسُقِيَهَا. So the Prophet, the ayah clearly says that they're shaqi. So that's what the Prophet said. Do you know the first shaqi, the first destroyed? Ali ibn Abi Talib said, aqir al-naqah. I mean, some narrations he said, Allah wa Rasulullah. The Prophet told him. Then the Prophet said to him, "Atidri man ashqal akhirin?" Do you know the latest one who is destroyed? Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, "Allah wa Rasulu alam." The Prophet said to him, "Man yadribuka ala rasik," Ali, the one who smacks you on your head. "Hatta taqtuba lihyataka bidamin," until your beard becomes poured with blood. Another narration says, until your legs become poured with blood. Albani authenticated this in the silsila, hadith al-sahiha. The Prophet referred to it as what? Ashqa al-akhirin. Abdurrahman, Imran al-Hitani saying what? Ya darbatan mittaqiyin, ma arada biha, illa liyabluga dhil arshi ridwana, sah? Walidhalika, these lines of poetry reached Abu Tayyib al-Tabari, rahimahullah, and he responded, and he said the following. He said, "Inni la abra'u mimma anta qailuh." I free myself in what you have said. "Ala ibn Muljim al-man'un buhtana," on Abdurrahman ibn Muljim, the liar. "Inni la adhkuruhu yawman fa'al'anuh," I remember him sometimes and I curse him. "Deenan," as a religion. "Wa al'anu Imran wa Hittana," and I curse you, Imran ibn Hittan. "Alayka thumma alayhi dahru muttasila," may curse be upon him and you forever. "La'ainu Allah israran wa i'lana," may it be upon you privately and publicly. "Fa'antum min kilabin nari ja'a bihi," you guys are from the dogs of the hellfire, as the textual evidence has come. "Nassu shari'ati tibyanan wa burhana," as the textual evidences came to prove and to state. So this illness is serious, brothers, which is najasatu ash-shubuhat. The person gets closer to Allah, yataqarrabu ila Allah. So one has to be very concerned. And two things fall under shubuhat. What are they? Najasatu shirki wa najasatu al-bid'ah. Najasatu shirk, the illness of shirk and the illness of innovation are the two things which are referred to as shubuhat. Kufr and bid'ah, they are shubuhat. Does the Christian believe he's getting closer to Allah, what he's doing? If you go to a Christian, I remember one brother, he said he was giving a da'wah to a Christian for so long. And on his deathbed, he said to the Christian, "Oh Christian," but of course he called him by his name. But he said to the Christian, "Take Islam. You're on your last moments in this world. If you say La ilaha illallah, you enter Jannah. It's your last chance. Take Islam." He said to him in response, "I am assured paradise already. Jesus has taken the sins for me. I'm going to go to paradise. It's nothing that I need to worry about. Take your misguidance away from me." So he believes in this. If he didn't, he would die upon Islam. Shubha is a problem, that's what it is. What he's doing, he believes is the truth. He believes it's the truth. The second one is taharatu min najasati shahawat. Cure yourselves from the illness of shahawat, desires. Shahawat is ma'asi, which is the third type of illness. There are two types I already mentioned, najasatu al-shirk, najasatu al-bid'ah, which are both known as najasatu shubuhat. The third one is najasatu al-ma'asiyah, illness of sins, which is known as shahawat. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions it all in his kitab al-fawa'id, and that's where he got it from originally. The author, rahimahullah, got these from the book of Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala. So, sorry. Then the author, وَلِمَا لِطَهَارَةِ الْقَلْبِ مِنْ شَأْنٍ عَظِيمٍ. Since, brothers, pay attention. And since there is a great affairs pertaining to the heart, أُمِرَ بِهَا النَّبِيُّ, the Prophet was commanded it. Since there is a powerful affairs and how the heart and its affairs is very serious, the messenger was commanded. في أول ما أمر به, from the early things that he was commanded was what? في قوله تعالى, in the statement of Allah, يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر وربك فكبر وثيابك فطهر. This was the second surah that came down in the Quran, right? وثيابك فطهر. Purify your what? Purify your heart. Purify your heart. Some people say, purify your clothes. This ayah, there's thalathatu aqwal, three opinions. What the word siyab means. There's thalathatu aqwal. The first qawl is al-amal, that it's actions. The second is that it's thiyabin, meaning your clothing, your outer clothing. And the third one, which is al-batin, your qalb, your internal. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, who chose the opinion, which is that it's your action. وَرَجَّحَ هَذَا الْقَوْلِ Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. And he said that the siyaq yuqawih, the context proves that. Because the Prophet was commanded actions, which was what? قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ Stand up and command and warn. So it was actions. So it makes more sense for the word thiyab to be used as action. And there are evidences that show that the word thiyab can actually be used for actions. The evidence for that is the hadith Al-Imam Abu Dawud narrated in his Sunan that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يُبْعَثُ كُلُّ عَبْدٍ عَلَى ثِيَابِهِ The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every slave is going to be resurrected the Day of Judgment with his clothing. عَلَى ثِيَابِهِ here doesn't mean clothes. It means upon the action which he used to do. Because we all know the Day of Judgment, no one's wearing clothes. The Prophet said, عُرَاتًا The people will come naked, no clothes. So this statement of Ibn Jarir al-Tabari as the word coming as thiyab, coming as amal, that hadith supports it, Albani authenticated it. As for it coming in the Arabic language, the word thiyab as qalb, it's found in the Arabs, the pre-Islamic, the shu'ara al-jahiliyyah, as is in the mu'allaqat al-ashara. The poet said, وَإِن تَكُ قَدْ سَاءَتْكِ مِنِّي خَلِيقَةٌ فَسُلِّي ثِيَابِي مِي ثِيَابَكِ تَنْسُلِي There was a woman he used to love. Or sometimes the woman is not true, is an imaginary figure they make just so they can bring the people into the point that they want to get to. So they do what is known as al-ghazal, am al-tashbib in shi'r. They talk about a woman for a little bit. بانت سعاد فقلبي اليوم بانت قلبي بانت قلبي بانت سعاد فقلبي اليوم متبول متيم إثرها لم يفت مكبول وما سعاد غداة البين إذ رحلوا إلا أغن غضيض الظرف مكحول هيفاء مقبلة عجزاء مدبرة لا يشتكى منه قصر ولا طول زهير بن أبي سلمة maybe this woman didn't exist. He just does it to get into the poetry Baytul Qasid. But the people will listen when a woman spoken about and the issue of women are brought up. Have you realized? Talk about marriage, the message is full. You don't know, people don't know where to stand, huh? Talk about ahkam and mas masail, people don't tend to come. Sah? So this individual was talking to a woman. He said to her, وَإِن تَكُ قَدْ سَاءَتْكِ مِنِّي خَلِيقَةٌ If my etiquette and the way I carried myself, it basically is something you disliked and it was harmful the way I dealt with you. فَسُلِّي ثِيَابِي مِنْ ثِيَابِكِ تَنْسُلِي Then strip my clothing from your clothing. Here he means, let's go our separate ways then. Take me from your heart, detach me from your heart. And I'll detach myself from your heart. And we'll go our separate ways. فَسُلِّي ثِيَابِي مِنْ ثِيَابِكِ Tansuli. Here, thiyab means qalb, your heart. Meaning, you don't have no love for me. He's trying to say to me, you're still going to love me even if you go away from me. So let's just stay together. Yeah. If you're all day thinking about me, shaking in bed, just thinking about me, we might as well spend the rest of our lives together, right? Adahu. That's what the qawl is. And Sheikh Salih ibn Abdullah ibn Hamad al-Usaymi, he wants to take this view, which is that thiyab here means qalb, because that's what he's proving here. So he's taking that third view. في قول من يفسر الثياب بالباطل وهو قول حسن and he said this is a قول which is حسن very good له مأخذ صحيح and I brought the مأخذ for it he didn't even bring it in his شرح I'm not relying on his شرح by the way I'm not using his شرح he says this is his شرح I have with me I looked at it but it's more of a تعليق than it's a شرح I'm explaining the متن word for word then the author says
قال المؤلف رحمه الله وفقه الله وإذا كنت تستحي من نظر مخلوق مثلك إلى وسخ ثوبك فاستحي من نظر الله إلى قلبك وفيه إحن وبلايا وذنوب وخطايا
The author رحمه الله here he says وإذا كنت تستحي If you are shy the word tastahyi fihi lughatan. There's two lugha. The word tastahyi. The word tastahyi, it has two languages, two usages. The first one is istahya. It comes from the word istahya. And if it comes from istahya, then when you bring it into the mudari', you say yastahyi, and you bring two yes. But if it comes from the word istaha, it only comes with one ya. When you bring it as the mudari', it becomes yastahyi, not yastahyi. You with me? That's why the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, you say, if you say, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ, then you have brought it from the word istahya. And if you say, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ, and you cut the ya off, it comes from the word istaha. ولذلك, I think, if I'm not wrong, in the qira'at, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَحِيِّ, you can say it with two ya's. And you can say it with one ya. Both of them are qira'at, sab'iyyatan, mutawatirat. Sah? Ya ahl qurra, where the qurra? Inna Allah la yastahyi, you can say, ama inna Allah la yastahyi an yadriba mathala ma ba'udatan fama fawqaha. Wa idha kunta tastahi min nadhar makhluq, if you are shy of a slave looking at you when you have a dirty clothes, and you don't want them to see that dirty clothes of yours, إِلَى وَسَخِ ثَوْبِكَ, you don't want somebody to see your dirty garment. فَاسْتَحِي مِن نَظَرِ اللَّهِ إِلَى قَلْبِكَ, then be shy of Allah looking at the dirty heart that you have. وَفِي إِحَنٌ, and in your heart is a إِحَن. إِحَن is ill-heartedness. You have an ill heart. وَبَلَايَا means problems. وَذُنُوبٌ means sins. وَخَطَايَا means shortcomings. So when you are shy, you say, no, I can't do khutbah with this garment, huh? Why? Because it's dirty. I want a clean thawb, a white, clean, iron thawb. Because I don't want people seeing me with a dirty thawb. Then you should be more shy of Allah seeing you with a heart. فيه إحن. In it is what? You're ill-hearted. وَبَلَايَا, and it has problems. وَذُنُوبٌ, and there are sins filled with that heart. وَخَطَايَا, and shortcomings. نعم. The word إِحَنٌ is إِحْنَا. It's the jam' of إِحْنَا. So that's how you say. You say إِحَنٌ.
قال وفقه الله. قال مسلم الحجاج حدثنا عمرو الناقد قال حدثنا كثير بن هشام قال حدثنا جعفر بن برقان عن يزيد العصم عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم وأموالكم ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم واحذر كما إن نفسك التي متى خرجت عليك كسرت كسر مهان من طهر قلبه فيه العلم الحل ومن لم يرفع منه نجاسته ودعه العلم وارتحل.
The author رحمه الله, he brings a hadith from Al-Imam Muslim ibn Hajjaj al-Naysaburi rahimahullah, the author of the second most authentic hadith book after Sahih al-Bukhari. And he says, حَدَّثَنَا عَمْرُ النَّاقِدِ is his sheikh. He narrates from his sheikh, who then narrates from Kathir ibn Hisham, Ja'far ibn Burqan, and Yazid al-Asam, who says, Abu Hurayra AbdulRahman ibn Musakhrin radiallahu ta'ala anhu, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن الله لا ينظر, Allah does not look at إلى صوركم, does not look at your forms. Some people, they spend time in the gym, right? يا إخوة, it's like they do اعتكاف in the gym. Yeah, they got six packs even on their ears. صح حمزة. Well, those people. But when you are, alhamdulillah, it's good to be healthy. You see, I shouldn't hate on that person, huh? No, it's good. But what is also needed is to know that Allah doesn't look at that. That doesn't concern Allah. Allah does not look at the person's heart, his physique, how big he is. Is he skinny? Is he short? Is he tall? Allah doesn't look at that. وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ, Allah doesn't look at your wealths. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَعَمَالِكُمْ. Rather, Allah looks at your hearts and your actions. There's something, a benefit that I need to mention, a very powerful benefit. In the old copies of Riyadh al-Salihin, the old copies, alhamdulillah, now many beautiful copies have come out, but in the old copies of Riyadh al-Salihin, there fell a mistake here, which is that it said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ أَجِسَامِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَعْمَالِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَعْمَالِكُمْ Some of the nusukh of Riyadh al-Salihin, this mistake fell into it. And subhanallah, some of the shurrah of Riyadh al-Salihin, because of the khata in the nuskha, because of the mistake in the copy, they explained it wrongly. If you go to the sharah, Dalil al-Falihin, if you go to it, written by Ibn Allan, his sharah of Riyadh al-Salihin, if you look at it, he explains it with that mistake. And Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah nabbaha ala dhalik, he pointed that out in his ta'liq of Riyadh al-Salihin. He has a ta'liq on it, Shaykh al-Albani. Maktabat al-Islami published it. So he rahimahullah, he pointed that out. So one has to be very careful that this narration is wrong. It doesn't exist. And even though we didn't bring it like that, it fell in a mistake of one of the nusakh's copy did that wrong. A nusakh is basically, brothers, alhamdulillah, now there's publishing companies, shop publishing houses, like Idar ibn Jawzi, Idar ibn Minhaj, and others. Back in the days, if I wanted to read Fathul Bari, I would go to a nasikh, a writer, who's a good writer, his handwriting is good, and his speed is good. I'll go to that individual and I'll say to him, brother, can you write Fathul Bari for me? And he will be like, brother, listen, right now I'm writing it for Fulan and Fulan. When I finish for them too, I'll come for you, inshallah. So people would wait for that one individual or those couple of people and they'll get paid for it. That person, can he fall into a mistake? Yeah, he can fall into a mistake. So sometimes he's writing, he's trying to get, if that person hasn't got wara, hasn't got fear of Allah, hasn't got, he might do many mistakes. How would you be able to overcome it? Is to get many copies, even many copies of his copies. Different times he wrote it, bring them together. The more copies that you get, the more accurate is going to be. And that's why it's important that when you're buying a book, you make sure the copy that you buy is good. Don't buy these cheap Egyptian copies, huh? Businessmen, they bring it out. 50 copies at the same time, 7 pages are the same. When you turn it around, same page again. Say, if you take it to shop, it's like, I sold it to you. I'm not going to sell it, I'm not going to take it back from you. Some books I have, like the kitab written by Al-Ala Al-Kaykildi, rahimahullah. His kitab, Qawa'id al-Madhab, Qawa'id al-Mudhab. 7, 8 pages are the same. He's turning over the same page all day. Some pages are blank white. And it is haram and it is not permissible to even buy. Some shops, they won't let you open it. There's a plastic bag over it, yeah? Or you say, oh, can I see the book before I buy it? They won't let you. Shara'an is not permissible. They have to let you see it. They can't let you see another copy. No, you have to show me this one itself, because I'm buying this one. That copy might be good, it might be the same company house, but this one might be different, might have a mistake in there, that this one doesn't have, sah? So I need to see each one. It's like somebody say to you, you want to buy Reebok shoes or Adidas, I'm going to show you just the same as the other one. I'm not going to let you open this one, I'm going to show you another one. No, I want to see this one, buying this one. The other one is somebody else's. Na'am. The author then brings, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ جِسَامِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ Allah doesn't look at your forms and your wealth. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ So what is it that Allah looks at? Allah looks at your heart and your actions. Because aqidatul murji'ah comes out from here, which is that the actions are not part of iman. And the actions are part of iman. A person has to have actions. So Allah looks at your actions. That's what Allah is observing, your actions. Are you? Where's the manifestation of this belief in the heart? It has to come. Then the author says, مَنْ طَهَرَ قَلْبَهُ فِي الْعِلْمِ حَلَّ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَرْفَعْ مِنْهُ نَجَاسَتَهُ وَدَعَ الْعِلْمُ وَارْتَحَلُ The author, rahimahullah, says, مَنْ طَهَرَ قَلْبَهُ Anyone who purifies his heart. فِي الْعِلْمِ in knowledge, حَلَّ Knowledge will settle in. If you purify your heart and you cleanse it, then knowledge will settle into your heart. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَرْفَعْ مِنْهُ نَجَاسَتَهُ And anyone who does not remove the filth in the heart and the dirt, وَدَعَهُ الْعِلْمُ الْعِلْمُ will greet you, bye, farewell, okay, and he will leave you. وَارْتَحَلَ And he will departure from you. Knowledge and you are not going to be together. نعم.
وَإِذَا تَصَفَّحْتَ أَحْوَالَ طَائِفَةٍ مِّن طُلَّابِ الْعِلْمِ فِي هَذَا الْمُعْقِدِ رأيت خللا بينا فأين تعظيم العلم من امرئ تغدو الشهوات والشبهات في قلبه وتروح.
The author رحمه الله says وإذا تصفحت if you turn over, تصحيف means pages, if you turn over the pages من طلاب, the students of knowledge. In other words, if you observe the situations pertaining to the students of knowledge, في هذا المعقد, in all these chapters to come, if you really look at people's situation and you observe them, رأيت خللا بينا, you're going to see a great deficiency, a clear deficiency. فأين تعظيم العلم? How is one honoring knowledge? How is one respecting and glorifying knowledge? How is one venerating knowledge? تغدو الشهوات والشبهات في قلبه وتروح. That doubts and desires are entering his heart morning and day. How can you be one who honors knowledge, respects knowledge, venerates knowledge, but all day you're swimming inside shahawat, desires, and shubuhat? You just come from a halaqa of a lesson. You just came from a Quran class. You just came from a circle of knowledge. And on the way home, you're listening to music. Kayf. Have you respected knowledge? Have you honored knowledge? Or you come to the masjid and you do your Quran madrasa, and then you go back and you hang around with bad friends. Have you honored the Quran? Have you honored the Prophet ﷺ's statements? Have you honored knowledge? Have you glorified knowledge? La. Or whenever it becomes dark, you go on sites that are haram. Have you glorified knowledge? You haven't honored knowledge, nor have you venerated knowledge. Not in any way. What it means to honor knowledge, number one, is tathiru al-ilm, the place that you want to put knowledge in. Akhi, if I bring you to my house and I say, akhi, wait for me in the toilet, would you accept that? And I say to you, stay here and wait for me here, and then I come to the toilet with you and then we start eating food in the toilet. Is that respect for you? Disrespect. How is it that you want to take knowledge and you haven't cleaned the place where you're going to put it in? And you're not observing the place that you want to put in the knowledge. And you don't really respect knowledge. Because if I do that and I put you in the toilet, that means I don't have no respect for you. Sah? And you're going to feel disrespected. Disrespected. Hadahu. That's all it is. That's what knowledge is. Nah.
تدعوه صورة محرمة وتستهويه مقالة مجرمة حشوه المنكرات والتلذذ بالمحرمات فيه غل وفساد وحسد وعناد ونفاق وشقاق أنى لهؤلاء وللعلم ما هم منه ولا هو إليهم. قال سهل بن عبد الله حرام على قلبي أن يدخله النور وفيه شيء مما يكره الله عز وجل.
The author then says تدعوه والضمير عائد إلى القلب. The ضمير, the pronoun here, goes back to knowledge. وتدعوه, knowledge calls, sorry, the heart calls him. Sorry, the heart is called. تدعوه, the heart is being called. صورة محرمة, an image that's haram. Videos, games, pictures, sites, is calling this person. وتستهويه مقالة المجرمة. And he's also been slipped and also been misguided with a statement that holds deviation in it. حشوه المنكرات, filled with evilness. والتلذذ بالمحرمات, and finding sweetness in sins. This person, he's, how have you honored knowledge? How have you respected knowledge? When all day your heart keeps calling you to, and you keep accepting from it things that are haram, videos, musics, raps, things like that. ولذلك, one of the things, if you read the kitab إغاثة اللهفان في مصائد الشيطان, Ibn al-Qayyim mentions in his kitab from the last fusul, when he talks about the adrar and the harm that the musiqa and the ghina has, Ibn al-Qayyim states clearly that one of the things that increases in a society homosexuality is music. And what do you call it? Sexual tendency. The person going on sites that have all of this is music. And do tatabbu, observe yourself. If a person opens up to the doors of music and listens to music and accepts music, that person is not stopped by what? Because Allah said in the Quran, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ وَأَجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجْلِكَ وَشَارِكُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ وَعِدْهُمْ وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. This sound that you hear from the music is show, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ. Sawt here means music. As the Mufassirin mentioned, taking you and sliding you and tricking you into all of the other haram through music. That's it. This rapper comes and he says, couple. Imagine that time when the ayah was coming down. The music that was listened to is nothing like this music today. Sah? The music today that we listen to, that our youngsters listen to, and that they are listening to and they open their ears to. I don't need to say more. Huh? Itself is sexual activities in it. The lyrics and everything that are being said. A man comes and he keeps talking about vulgar statements, vulgar statements. Have you really honored knowledge? Have you really respected knowledge after listening to all the ayat and the hadith and you walk out? That's disrespect. It's like somebody inviting you into his house, allowing you to eat from his house, taking care of you, allowing you to stay in his house, eat and say, don't worry, what do you need? Gives you money, gives you gifts and sends you away, and you start dissing him and insulting him after you left his house. That's exactly what it is. That when you listen to the Quran and you listen to the hadith, and you listen to knowledge, then you walk away and you open the doors for al-shahawat al-shubuhat. And you're enjoying, you're finding taladhudh. Ya ikhwe, you have to enjoy one or two. You either have to enjoy knowledge and what it brings, or you have to enjoy haram and that which it brings. Taladhudh is only for one of the two. So here this person is finding taladhudh bil-muharramat. Fi ghillun wa fasad. This person's heart is ill. Corruptions in his heart. Hasad, jealousy. Jealousy is another issue. That you don't want anybody else to lift their head up except you. That's the only person. You want to be the known one. You want to be the appreciated one. You want to discredit the person. Hasadun, wa nifaqun, hypocrisy. You deal with the people in one way, and the reality behind closed doors is something totally and utterly different. Wa shiqaqun, shiqaqiyah means opposing the truth. In your heart, you're opposing the truth. You're setting yourself stones of how to oppose the truth. The Sheikh says, "Anna lihaulai walil'ilm." How can these people? And where is knowledge for them? There's no knowledge. Al-ilmu fi wadin wa hum fi wadin. They're on one valley, and knowledge is on another valley. Sarat musharriqatan wa sirta mugharribin fashatana bayna musharriqin wa mugharribi. That's the east, and you're in the west, and the east and the west are not close to each other. Ma hum minhu, they are nothing to do with knowledge. Wala huwa ilayhim, and nothing, knowledge has nothing to do with them. They have no relationship with each other. Then the author brings the statements of Sahal ibn Abdullah Tustari. Sahal ibn Abdullah Tustari. Sahal ibn Abdullah Tustari is from the Zuhad, one of the well-known aesthetic scholars. And it was said that one day he came to Al-Imam Abu Dawood rahimahullah, and he told Abu Dawood, I'm going to ask you for something. Promise me you're not going to say no to me. And Abu Dawood, rahimahullah, said, I promise I won't. I mean, I promise I will do for you what you asked for me. So he said to him, bring out your tongue. Abu Dawood stuck out his tongue and he kissed his tongue. Abu Dawood said, why did you do that for? And he said, I wanted to kiss a tongue that narrates the hadiths of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now that's not something you should do. That's not something I'm encouraging you to do. I just wanted to mention it since it's something. And things like that remind you of a person's name. That's why. Sah? When you hear a strange thing, you will never forget the name of that person. Sa'al ibn Abdullah Tustari was min al-zuhad, from the most aesthetic, who boycotted his dunya and turned towards the hereafter. He said, haramun ala qalbin. It is haram. And this haram, as we said, al-hurmatu ta'ti ala nawaini. Haram comes in two meanings, right? Haram which is qadari, and haram which is shar'i. Haram which is qadari is what? وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَحَرَامٌ عَلَىٰ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهُ. صح? Those tahrim are tahrim qadari. Because when Allah says, وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ, Allah is talking about Nabi Allah Musa's mother and him. Allah prohibited Musa from suckling the breast of any other woman. Allah says, وَحَرَّمْنَا حَرَّمْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الْمَرَاضِعِ. All the nurses, when they came and they tried to breastfeed Musa, he wouldn't take it. Allah prevented him from it. Only person whose breast he accepted is who? His mother. And you have to understand here, wallahi, look how when you rely on Allah. Are you with me, brothers? ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما منهم ما كانوا يحذرون وأوحينا إلى أم موسى أن أرضعي فإذا خفت عليه فألقيه في اليم ولا تخافي ولا تحزني إنا رادوه إليك وجعلوه من المرسلين فالتقطه آل فرعون ليكون لهم عدوا وحزنا. Here Allah mentions to us, وَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَلْأَرْضَعِي. Pay attention to this, brothers. This is a latifah I have to mention. Which is Nabiullahi Musa's mother. Nabiullahi Musa's mother, Allah commanded her to throw her child into the sea. And the correctest opinion regarding this verse is means that she, whenever Fir'aun and his army would come, she would take Musa and she would put him in a basket. It is not correct to say that she took him and she put him on the basket and she let him go into the water. She didn't do that. That's not what she did. No mother can do that. And Allah will not request a mother to do that. But the qawl al-sahih is that she tied her son Musa to the house because she lived on a bank, a river flowing right next to her house. So she would tie him on the basket, a rope on the basket, and she would tie the rope at the top on the door window. And so when they come, they would look if she has any children and they would leave. And she would take him, she would bring him up again. One day, she didn't tie it properly. So Allah commanded her to place it in the basket and to put it in the water, but He didn't send her, tell her to sell it to Fir'aun. So then Musa went to Fir'aun like that. Look what happened. She relied on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she gave in to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happened after that? Her son did not just come to her. First of all, Allah took to show you the ability and the strength of Allah. Musa grew up in the house which his mother feared for him. Fir'aun raised him, his own enemy. Not only that, Allah brought Musa back to his mom. Not only that, Allah made Fir'aun pay for the breastfeeding of the mother. She was getting paid for breastfeeding her own child. So she had better than what she expected, right? Now she's got no one to fear. Second is that she's getting paid for seeing her son. She's getting money for it. That's the result and the fruit of a person who fully gives his affairs to Allah and has tawakkul in Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. Allah does not forsake the righteous deed of a good person. So what happened was, Sahal ibn Abdullah's statement is حَرَامٌ أي حُرْمَةُ الْقَدَرِيَّةِ. حُرْمَةُ الشَّرْعِيَّةِ, we're not talking about it, which is مَا يُعَاقَبُ عَلَى تَارِكِهِ وَيُثَابُ عَلَى فَاعِلِهِ. That's not what he means here. حَرَامٌ عَلَى قَلْبٍ means حُرْمَةُ الْقَدَرِيَّةِ. It won't happen. عَلَىٰ قَلْبٍ a person, قَلْبٍ a heart, أَنْ يَدْخُلَهُ النُّورُ, that light will enter his heart, وَفِي شَيْءٌ مِمَّا يَكْرَهُهُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. And in it is something which Allah dislikes. Knowledge will not enter a heart of a person. The light of knowledge will not enter a heart of a person. In that heart, there's something Allah dislikes. Nope. Clean it first. And this is in agreement with قوله تعالى سأصرف عن آياتي الذين يتكبرون في الأرض بغير الحق. Allah says, I will divert my verses from those who are arrogant on this earth بغير الحق, without the truth. Sufyan ibn Uyayna, he said in the tafsir of this ayah, أحرمهم فهم القرآن, I will prevent them from understanding the Quran, because previously they didn't clean their hearts. There was arrogance in their hearts, rejection of the truth. So what's happening here? Because they didn't clean their hearts, Allah said, I'm diverting their hearts from the truth. سَأَصْرِفُ عَنْ آيَاتِيَ الَّذِينَ يَتَكَبُّرَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. So he says, أَحْرِمُهُمْ فَهْمَ الْقُرْآنِ. The understanding of the Qur'an will be prohibited from them. Muhammad ibn Yusuf al-Faryabi, he says, أَمْنَعُ قُلُوبَهُمْ مِنَ التَّدَبُّرِ فِي أَمْرِي. I'm going to prevent them, their hearts, from pondering in my commands. Also, Ibn al-Hajj in his kitab al-Madkhal, he says, وَمَعْلُومٌ أَنَّ بَعْضَ الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ يَحْفَظُ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَكِنَّهُمْ مُنِعُوا فَائِدَتَهُ فِي الْفَهْمِ وَالْعَمَلِ وَذَلِكَ هُوَ الْمَطْلُوبِ. It is known that many of these people, they memorize the Qur'an. يُقِيمُونَ حُرُوفَهُ. They are able to pronounce and articulate it. Every makhraj is correct. Nah? Every makhraj, he will read it. حُصَرِ, he will read it properly. But what is it that they are prevented from? وَلَكِنَّهُمْ مُنِعُوا فَائِدَتَهُ. But they are prevented from benefiting فَإِدَتَوْ فِي الْفَهْمِ وَالْعَمَلِ in understanding what they are reading. وَالْعَمَلِ and the implementation. وَذَلِكَ هُوَ الْمَطْلُوبِ. And the ultimate reason of the Qur'an is what? كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِ أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. The whole ghaya of the inzal of the Qur'an was what? Implementation and to understand what's in it. That's the ultimate goal of the Qur'an. They are unable to attain that. The reason is because they became ones who did not purify their vessels. So before the haqq came to them, their hearts was already filled with misguidance and corruption. Insha'Allah ta'ala, I will stop there bi-idhnillah al-kareem, this kitab. We've done one ma'aqid, and tomorrow we'll carry on and we'll finish this book, Ta'zim al-Ilmi. Every day we're going to do it. Because some people are not going to come today, they want to come tomorrow. Other people are going to come next day after. So we're going to do now, insha'Allah ta'ala, the next kitab, which is Al-Qawa'id al-Arba'ah.